about to get to the top five restaurants, but first we want to talk about some of the restaurants that didn't make the cut, some that just missed the cut, and some rising stars. So, you know, John, here in Toronto, Scaramouche, perennial great restaurant for generations, but it didn't make the top 100. Why do you think that is?
I'm quite shocked, actually. I think because there's a lot of restaurants in the country, there's more and more every day coming on the scene. And a lot of these restaurants are getting a lot of airplay, and I just think that Scaramouche just isn't getting the kind of airplay that the other restaurants are getting. And yeah, quite a surprise.
Another one, Bishop's in Vancouver. Folks like Vikram Vij, he started there, and you know, they one of those spots that just didn't get the support this year. Very deserving list. Eigenson Farm at Singhampton.
You know, Chef Statlander and his team, they deliver an incredible taste experience. I think, really, quite frankly, one that is highly unique to Canada. So surprising, but, you know, I think he also has so many great events that it's kind of interesting that those might be a little bit more accessible. Mm-hmm. And he's got one coming up soon, the Wild Leek Festival. So if you hadn't had a chance to dine at the farm, this is a great opportunity to do so.
Yeah, and Eigenson Farm, great restaurant. It is a $300 a night experience, very, very difficult to afford for most people. So that's why perhaps it's not on there. A couple that just missed that were on last year, Rene Au Pied de Cochon. I know that one was one of your favorites.
I think one of the things with Au Pied is that perhaps there is so much going on right now in Montreal itself. A lot of great new places, and like Le Cabane, which did make our list, very exciting things happening that perhaps some perennial favorites just didn't come to the top of the list just because most of the folks voting had also been there previously.
And you're really upset that Splendido didn't get on.
I'm a little touch upset. I believe it's number 51.
It just missed the
just
cut.
Just missed the cut. Splendido, if anything, has delivered to me the top restaurant experience I've had here in the country, equivalent to what I would consider something like a 2-Michelin star level performance. So the crew there, they're fantastic. But perhaps it's a reflection of where people are going out nowadays. Not to say that there isn't a room for fine dining, but there are a lot of other options that people are going out to seek.
And a couple of others, Barefoot Bistro, wonderful restaurant in Whistler by Melissa Craig, the chef there, Eden and Banff, another terrific one. But, you know, the restaurants in this country continue to improve. You've got Marban here, they're one shining star that we can look for next year. Then a couple of others, Bar Isabel here in Toronto.
Yeah, just recently opened, very stellar team, a really strong front of house, and I don't want to say even stronger, but equally strong back of house.
And, Carl Heinrich's Richmond Station.
Yes, Carl and Ryan are doing amazing work at Richmond Station. I love the menu, love the setting and the atmosphere. It's only a couple of blocks from work, so I'm lucky, close to home. Love what they're doing on their menu. And again, the service there is actually, it's really great to see in the city of Toronto and in Canada as a whole, our service level rising. And I hope we continue to see that. And I think some of these new restaurants, they're really putting that focus on service, which is wonderful.
And just a couple other quick ones to look out for. Maison Publique in Montreal, Chef Derek Damon, Jamie Oliver, famous chef, he's one of the partners there. Wildebeest in Vancouver, they're doing some great things. Dale McKay is going to be opening a new bistro in Saskatoon. And we've seen on this list, Alberta and Saskatoon are really getting some great representation. Dining in this country is changing overnight almost. Right back with the top five.